What I took from the first panel is that there is this really this urgency to act. There are so many big challenges ahead. And what is key to all those challenges is that they are so much interconnected. They very much express high levels of interdependency, for instance, between human life and nature, or between sectoral systems, or between different places, right? And what I see in the field is that on the one hand, we seem to realize that this that we are have to deal with this high level of interdependency by including more holistic understanding of what is the planning agenda, calling for circular cities, healthy cities, livable cities, all very holistic concepts. But on the other hand, I worry, do we take these interdependencies actually serious, right? Because they have an extreme high level of complexity. And that implies that, you know, one particular change in one part of the city or in one subsystem can actually lead to a cascade of effects. Think of how online shopping disrupted retail districts, and individual entrepreneurs and shop owners are adapting to that, right? Transforming their shops into coffee places to meet, to hang out, to do your work, and therefore actually contributing to a bigger transformation on what is the function of that street, no longer a shopping street, but the kind of public living room. So this kind of spontaneous processes are very much going on in the city and are shaping the trajectories of cities. They are hard to adapt. They are hard to predict, sorry. But they also have they also make clear that cities have a kind of intrinsic capacity to adapt. And of course, the key question for me is how to balance that, right? Not all spontaneous developments are necessarily the kind of spontaneous developments that we want. But on the other hand, it would be rather naive to ignore them. So my call here is, you know, not only to plan for establishing desired changes and aim to control the path to reaching that change, but actually also to support cities in their own capacity, their intrinsic capacity to deal with uncertainty. So this means, for instance, rules, regulations that allow for a bit of change within certain boundaries. It's a call for more flexibility in design, also building maybe more for temporality instead of indeed this long time periods. And I think what that means for the role of planners is, first of all, to make this complexity tangible. We have wonderful tools for doing that. And to also look how we can team up with it, indeed this more spontaneous processes. And to make sense of what's going on, I think the Urban Future Studio, for instance, in the Netherlands is doing great work on that, on also combined with art. And of course, to monitor and evaluate, right? We need time to reflect. So it should be compulsory in every project. There should be 10% of the budget should be reserved for doing that. It's often not happening. So how then to learn from this? So we need not only to prepare our cities for the future, but also to make our cities future-proof.